Hi my lovelies, welcome back to my channel. So today's makeup look, I did this beautiful smoky glittery eyes paired up with some classic red lips. Now this is a perfect makeup for a date night, for Valentine's Day, even if you're going to someone's wedding, like as a guest, or even as a bride, you can definitely pair up something like this. This is beautiful, very classic. It's very wearable with a plain white outfit or a plain black outfit. To me, I would love to wear this with a plain black outfit, especially on a night, because this shimmer on the eyes, the glitter, it's gonna look so stunning at nighttime. So let's dig right into the tutorial. First thing first, I'm applying some primer. This is the one by e.l.f. This is their putty primer. This is called putty pudding primer. No, sorry, my bad. Luminous putty primer, that's what it's called. It's by e.l.f. It has a little bit of shine to it. It's perfect. Now to prep my eyes, I've used my LA Girl concealer, and the shade I've used, it's in the shade light ivory. Now this will help pop my eyeshadows more. Today's eyeshadow palette is this Magical Rose by Golden Reflection palette. I have used this palette in my previous tutorials as well. This is my second time using this and I'm totally in love with it. The first color that I'm using is a color called Fear, which is a very kind of like a subtle blush tone. And it's beautiful. It works perfectly for the crease transition. But this color is going to get a little overcome by another color, which is the black eyeliner. Now the black eyeliner that I've used for today's is the L'Oreal gel eyeliner in shade black, and taking an angular brush, I'm making sure it covers my entire lid. Once it is done, I took some powder on my brush. The color that I'm using right now is called Sleeping Beauty from the same palette, mixed with some Cursed, which is kind of like a brownish tone. And then here I'm just kind of blending and marrying the colors and the eyeliner together. So then the next color I'm using, the Sleeping Beauty. And now I'm creating a transition that is more towards the brown side. And now it starts to take over that pinkier shade that I've used earlier. Now using some glitter glue, you don't really have to use it if you're using fingers. I try to use like brush, but it looks like it works better with the fingers. So here I'm trying to just apply with the brush. I could get it, but it was very hard for me to blend the glitter with a brush. So I used my fingertips and it works perfectly. Fingertips is always the best way to blend, in my opinion, so it's perfect. And the shade of this glitter is called Dark. Now it does have a little bit of like reflex of kind of like a pinkier reflex. It does have a black and pink reflex in it. So it's not totally like deep black. It has a little bit of that reflex, which was perfect. Now for some mascara, I'm using my Maybelline mascara. This is their Snapscara line. And recently I've been using this mascara quite a bit. And now I'm going to use the same company's, which is the Golden Reflection, their lashes. And this is in the name called Drama Queen. Oh my gosh, yep, Drama Queen it is. But I love it. I love the shape of this lashes. Once I wear them, you're gonna see it. It's gonna look so beautiful. So it is advised that you wear something heavier in terms of lashes when doing smoky eyes, because if you have black as your background and your lash is very like natural, it's gonna all blend in and it won't show. So it's always nice to have like a little bit of heavier lashes just to pop those eyes. Now, after doing my other eyes, I'm applying my foundation. And for today's foundation, I'm going with the 320, which is a natural tan bronze natural foundation. This is the Fit Me Matte Poreless Foundation. And using my beauty blender, I'm just blending it all into my skin. And also make sure you do cover your necks. Once that is all blended, we're gonna now apply our cream concealer. For the cream concealer, I'm going to be using Stella Beauty's concealer, and it is in the shade S02. And I'm basically concealing my higher points of my face. And because it is a black eyeshadow, you do want your under eyes to pop a little bit more. Make it look a little bit more brighter, because otherwise it's going to end up looking like a raccoon eyes if you have dark eyes or dark circles. If you want to counter dark circles, you could apply an orange concealer or an apricot color. Those two are pretty good, like an apricot or an orange concealer. These are pretty good. Now, using the same beauty blender, I'm just blending all of that into my face. Once it is all blended, I'm gonna move on to the next step, which is to set my under eyes. I'm using my Charlotte Tilbury's powder to set my under eyes. Now, before I even do that, I'm always going to go in with a smaller brush and blend the lines on my under my eyes, so there's no lines, absolutely no crease, no lines. And then I like to go with a bunch of powder and kind of go and dab right in. If you don't want to go with a bunch of powder, you can always use just powder. But always make sure, before you even set it with powder, you make sure that your foundation there is perfectly blended and there's no line. If there's a line and the foundations are all like stuck in between the lines, go ahead and blend it out first before you put the powder. Here, I literally could just kept the powder for a few seconds and I started like dusting away my entire face, and I just, you know, applied some extra powder on my remaining of the areas where I didn't apply with my like a baking mode. So if we don't bake our entire face, so wherever we are not baking, make sure you apply loose powder to set those areas as well. Now, for contour, I'm using this Marcel bronze. This is matte, and it is in the shade dark bronze 04, so this is probably their darkest. And I'm just basically contouring away my face and using some bronzer. I know that you're not supposed to contour with a bronzer, but you know what? I'm making this tutorial a very easy step to follow, not too many things. But if you want something that's more intense, not like a party makeup, you want more like a bridal look, then you would want to have something with a little bit more steps, like doing the cream contour, cream highlight, you know, a lot of those things. For the blush, I'm using the Tarte blush, and this is in the shade Partay. I love the shade. This is beautiful. For my under eyes, I'm using the same color Fear from the same palette. If you don't want to use like a pinkier color, you can totally go with something else. I just went with a little bit of the pink tone to kind of bring the Valentines into the makeup tutorial, you know, because Valentines is all about the pinks and the reds, so I just wanted to bring that in. But you can totally do brown instead of like pink, totally up to you. And then now, going for my eyebrows, I'm using my Kiss Professionals eyebrows. This is in the shade, I know it's a semi matte brow pencil, but this is in the shade medium brown. Once it's all done, I'm just using a brow setter by Benefit Cosmetics to set my brows in. It's kind of like a gel formula that keeps your brow hairs in place. Next, it's time for some highlighter. I'm gonna pop some highlighter on my corner of my eyes, on my inner corner of my eyes. And I'm using a highlighter to do that. Also do my brow bones as well with the same highlighter, which is the Maybelline highlighter in the shade 100. I haven't contoured my nose yet, so you're gonna see me contour my nose very soon. Here I'm just highlighting my higher points of my face, and honestly guys, this is one of my favorite highlighters, the Maybelline highlighters. It is so beautiful. It blends in like a cream. There is no glitter particles in there. It's just beautiful. It gives a very beautiful glow to the face. Amazing. So after I've done my highlight, I kind of went in a reverse mode. Now I'm just contouring my nose. For that, I'm using the same powder by Marcel. This is their bronzing powder, and I'm just contouring it lightly on the sides of my nose. For lipstick, I've used the same company's lipstick from the Golden Reflection. They're the same company whose palette I was using today for today's tutorial. Also, I'm going to be using the same company's lipstick. This is in the shade Scarlet. It's a beautiful red color, but I feel like it has a little bit of that, it's not a matte lipstick. It's pretty much a very satin lipstick, so it has a little bit of shine already, as if you can see it. It's very noticeable. There's like a shine to it. And then I'm just loving this because it has a little bit of shine and orange, a tint of orange in it. So it complements my skin tone really, really well. All right, so to just shape my lips, I'm using the Tarte lip liner here. You can use any lip liner of your choice to go ahead and kind of go around the lips. So it shapes very well and it looks very proportionate. And that's pretty much it, guys. I'm gonna actually spray some makeup setting spray, but this is what the eye makeup looks like, and this is what the face makeup looks like. This locket actually says my name in Bengali, so I definitely wanted to wear this for this look because it looks so cute. But anyways guys, this is the final look of this makeup look today. I hope you're gonna love this, and if you happen to try this makeup look out for this Valentine's Day, I know it's COVID time, most of us are staying home, but then if you are living with your partner or your loved one, it doesn't hurt to celebrate the Valentine's at home. Make your day so special at home. So do that, and let me know if you guys happen to recreate this makeup look. Definitely tag me on Instagram at MakeupbyAzmeree. Thank you so much for watching this tutorial guys. I'll see you next time on my next video. Till then, take care, and don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Hope to see you next time on my next video. Till then, stay safe and take care.